that was the right move. Maybe he could have gone out and then gone out power up side. But that just didn't really work out for him. He did manage to steal away an enemy RA, but I don't know that it was enough. So Absu is going to touch the flag once again. However, UM doing a good job on the defense. Let's see if they can keep it locked down.
Right, well, we've got power-up spawning in about 40 seconds. That's going to be pretty critical. But Tija just rolls through Mariju. He has the flag, and he's going to bring this thing home because he's on his side of the map. And for those that have listened to Quake Live TV's cast, you know that on this map, usually once you turn the corner through the center, you're done. Because at that point, it's pretty rare when you're going to run into another opposing player. So, kick Annie with a pick grab. Not very long-lived, though. Hope Joe had a rocket switch to rail.
And does this kind of feel like toying just a little bit? I don't know, maybe not Abso. Go ahead.
It's the heat, you know, like Kick definitely has the pressure. And we're seeing this thing where UM doesn't, again, they don't really know how to recover from the constant grabs of this flag. You know, they don't know how to kind of reset the pace. And that can be a really, really critical skill to learn. I think over time, as they play more, maybe they'll figure out, you come back on D when this happens, or you push out to center and hold it down because we need that location in our hands in the next 20 seconds, like that type of thing. And over time, we'll probably see that come together from these guys. I mean, I'm impressed with the D that they're rolling right now, quite frankly.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty good. I mean, Kick right now, I think, is making some really poor just decisions on some of the things that they're doing, some of the routes they're taking. Like, I mean, I don't know if they really are just kind of like, this is a more of a scrim to them. But for a team that had such an impressive game versus Lowland Lions, you know, this kind of seems like they're selling themselves short a little bit. But I don't know. I mean, they could just be kind of messing around that way. And there you go. Okay. Now nice you're thinking, there. Use your brain a little bit there. The 16 points of health, he's going to make his way down. Not even going to go for that YA because he thinks he's got it. And you know what? He's right. He does. There's a second cap. And he will kill himself right.
He was actually smart to do that because I heard a rail come in just behind his left ear as he made the turn. So I think had he gone for that YA, it would have been a gamble because he was so low on health. Had he picked up, one of those items, he basically would need to have all of it in order to survive the rails.
Right.
So it was actually a smart move. Pretty close, though.
Well, 15 minutes now, one quarter's down. We got a long time left in this game. NBC does have that haste. He's got double haste right now, 51 points of health. Although double haste does not guarantee you stay alive. So, you move fast and shoot fast, it doesn't mean shit if you take two rockets to the face. So you got to be careful about that. Is that exactly what NBC's doing? He's going to go ahead and take advantage of the fact that he got double power-ups. He's going to steal away this RA. And then instead of going through the teleporter, which is really smart, he's going to go out through the middle, uses that LG, rocket jump up to the top. He's got to just avoid a couple shots here. He's got it. This one is going to go all the way
home. He got the railer on a reload and just destroyed him with his rockets. And that's cap number three, unless something amazing happens, because he stacked up. And I really like the patience there. You know, having the double haste, and actually he's going to use it to get back out to center as well. But having the double haste, he was really patient to wait out for that armor. And a lot of times we see people like, oh, I've got haste, so I need to run as far as I can, as fast as I can. Yeah, it's going to be pulled out of midair. Cyber Demon has the flag on the red team, and he's going to try to, he's probably going to take the teleporter here, but he's not waiting for any armor. He would be waiting for about 15 seconds if he did. And he's at center, but he's got no help. So he's about to be stuffed. Both ends. Oof, that looked painful.
Yeah, that, if he would have just had a couple more seconds on that haste that he had, I think he probably would have pulled something out there. A double cap on the same haste. Like, that would be pretty amazing. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. 3-0 now. As I'm still watching NBC, he's on his side, and he's just going to wait for that mega and then go in and make another attack. I do see that we got a little bit of time left over until the next power-up, so no reason to get haste all on that.
Right.
So we'll see here. 13 minutes and 18 seconds. Batista is going to get another grab. And this is just not looking that great for UM. This is more of a nice display of how well Kick can play this map.
Yeah. Oh, and I'm watching Regen goes to NVC. Haste was picked up, I think, also by Kick. Yeah, Abzu's got it. And he dodges the rocket. He's got RA, so now he can decide his exit. He takes the teleporter and walks into a railgunner who cannot hit the hasted flag carrier. This is cap number 4, Wheat.
Yep.
Three, it is.
Can't even go away to try to steal it away. That'll be halfway to the cap limit. 12 minutes, 35 seconds on the clock. Not sure if that's what the goal is of this Kick team, but certainly they probably would like to finish it as quickly as they could and just try to be done with it.
They want to watch IEM too.
yeah, exactly. Annie is going to grab that flag. 12 minutes, 14 seconds. He's going to go past one LG'er, a second LG'er. They'll kind of run into each other. And that will allow him to get a couple feet further, but not enough to go anywhere with that flag. So they're just holding on for dear life.
Yeah. Omnivore has been rocking a 46% rail, and he's in sort of a typical position right now, while moving a little bit too forward, in my humble opinion. Going close range. He's able to get the frag, but he exposed himself to damage he did not need to take. Sitting back, you can get a rail. He's shaking off his mouse there. There's Mega for him. Nice, going up again. Now see, going that close, he goes straight into the LG range. Whereas, if he used the advantage of his weapon, he could be backing off and expanding the gap rather than closing it. And he would have won that fight because, an LG from that far of a gap is totally useless. So, kind of a weird decision, I would say. Questionable one.
Yeah, I think I've seen a couple of those, to be honest with you. But that's okay. 11 minutes on the clock. Still plenty of time for things to happen. We got NVC with that haste. We see him doing some serious damage with that thing. Abso is going to grab. Oh, Abso! Getting a taste of his own medicine there as he is just shoved into the corner with that shotgun, absolutely devastated as he did pick up that regen, and now NVC is going to have haste and regen. The flag, though, was stuck up top. Has it been returned? It's still stuck here over there. It finally got returned, but
It's actually a mistake, though. I think they've forgotten about NVC. He is in red space taking their RA. He's got a face-off against two. He's using a rail and getting LG down, but he's got a little bit of help. Mariju is down. Batija grabs the flag, and he gets help from NVC. And Batija is on his way out.
Oh, no.
He runs into two, but look at this. He's backing off, though. He's trying to give his team time to give him a chance to get out of this base. Here's Red Armor. Here's his second chance. And we're rolling around to the halfway point. Batija is on the way. Runs into great LG. And now here is Pope Joe with an LG of his own. And that's, shafted from both ends, Wheat.
Dude.
I don't think there was food there either.
He should have known that Mega was going to be there. And he should have gone right out, right onto that Mega, and then down to power up. But
yeah. It
doesn't really matter. It's not like that was the cap that was going to decide the game. I just feel like now they're just kind of playing to play as a UM holding on. 9 minutes, 30 seconds left on the clock. 4-0 in favor of Kick, and it looks like they will be your third place winner here for BIBS.
Yep. Unless something spectacular happens in the next 10 minutes, I think that's probably where we'll be. Let's go take a look at the carrier. It's going to be Annie, and he's trying to get out. He does stuff Mariju with a great bit of LG, but he's still got to face off against Pope Joe. Let's take a look at accuracies. Pope Joe, of course, was our pre-game interview. And take a look, he's rocking a 27% rail, 20% LG. And we just saw and heard power-ups picked up. Here comes Hasted NVC. He's on the way out and actually misses the RJ. Now he's trying to figure out where to go. He's getting help from his teammates, pushing him along with LG, and this is going to be cap number 5, Wheat. So he's turned the corners. Mariju being sneaky, grabbing the flag, but does not get reeled off. Lands one rocket, but with 21 health, you got to be thinking, how is he going to get out of here with his life?
Well, he goes out, and the Mega's just waiting for him. It's And he might actually get out of here. He fumbles a little bit, and that will be his downfall. Not knowing your routes and not having a straight line.